My next guest is a beautiful young actress from TV shows like Dexter and Chuck. She stars in the movie I, Frankenstein in theaters next Friday. Please take a look.
If Frankenstein was real, if he really did animate a human, would it help you to study it?
Well, yes, absolutely. But Mr. Wessex, it would have to be over 200 years old by now. There would be nothing left but a few brittle bones.
It's the first and only one of its kind, Dr. Wade.
Who's to say how long such a subject might live?
Please welcome the very sexy Yvonne Strahovski. I happen to have a very good friend from Australia, and she says, I've never heard that last name.
My last name?
Yeah. Because you're from Australia, right?
I'm from Australia, but I'm the only Australian in my family, because everyone's from Poland.
Oh.
So my parents migrated to Australia and had me.
Gotcha. So there's a reason why she didn't know anyone with that last
name. That's right, yes. The skis come from Poland, not Australia. My last name, Strahovski.
Gotcha.
Yes.
Gotcha. And where are you living right now?
I want
your address and your... No.
I live in Malibu, actually. I just moved. I threw the towel in and 3 months ago and rented a place in Malibu because I started surfing recently. So I've just been beach bumming around.
Yeah. And you have some good news for fans. Fans of Yvonne and fans of 24.
I do, yes.
I'll let you break it.
Oh, really? Okay, well, I've just recently joined the cast for the 12 episodes that they're doing, which is going to air in May, I believe.
That's
so,
cool.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes. Fans, do you know Kiefer?
I just met Kiefer last night at the TCAs, yeah.
Cool. What does that acronym stand for? TCA is what?
Television Critic.
Yeah.
Association or Awards? Association. No, Association, right?
Yep. Yep, so you know him. And are they shooting these in London?
Yeah, so basically, my life is kind of a whirlwind because we just announced it, and I'm getting on a plane in 2 days to go there. Well, to go to New York first to promote I, Frankenstein, the movie that's coming out, and then off to London to start shooting. So it's a big leap.
Yeah. Speaking of I, Frankenstein, were you a Frankenstein fan?
I wouldn't say I was a Frankenstein fan. I was aware of the book, and I had read it. But this movie is a completely different take on the traditional Frankenstein stories.
We sort of
springboard off of the novel, which was written about 200 years ago by Mary Shelley, and we jump into the present day, and we're creating this whole new world where we have gargoyles and demons, and the gargoyles represent the good and the demons are the bad guys, and there's this whole whirlwind of a war sort of going on that the humans don't really know about. And I play one of only two humans in the movie.
That sounds interesting. See, I'll go see it just from this description. Now, I meant to ask you, did you move to Malibu because you're into surfing or
yes.
that kind of stuff?
So
I love
just,
the water.
Well, no, I don't.
Oh.
It's embarrassing as an Australian to admit that I don't like the water. I'm scared of it. But I just recently started this summer surfing. It just sort of happened by fluke. I just got forced really to stand up on a surfboard, and I liked it so much that I just started doing it.
Yeah.
But yeah.
What are you afraid of? Like sharks or?
I'm afraid of sharks, and I'm afraid of just generally not really being able to see what's beneath me.
Right.
Around me, really. So.
Yeah. But bathwater, you're cool. Like you can stand in the bath. You're good.
Bathwater is cool as long as it's not dirty. You know, I have to be able to see through it. To the
right.
Bottom.
I get that. I'm from Cleveland, and that's exactly the way I am. Yes. And I grew up playing at Lake Erie. I hear that you have kind of fantasies of being a pop star.
I do. That.
Really?
It's a bit embarrassing to admit, but
no, we all have stood in the mirror with a brush or a perfume bottle and pretend to be Katy Perry. Maybe it's just me.
I can relate to that. I grew up a dancer, so I've always loved pop music. Unashamedly, I love pop music. Mm-hmm. Especially Katy Perry. I love Katy Perry.
Oh, you like Katy?
I do. I love her songs. I love Fireworks, my favorite.
Can you sing?
No.
You can't sing.
I can't. So, which is why it's a fantasy.
But you got the moves.
I have some moves, yeah. I do have kind of like a little signature move that I've been doing for many years. Mostly the goofy moves.
I'm sorry.
It's like,
it looked like a soulful jazz hands for a moment that jumped off. What, give me that again. What was that?
Well, the move, I have to stand up to do
it. Okay, I'll stand up with you.
Oh, we can.
Because see, here's the thing. Here's the thing about... See, I'm older than you.
Yeah.
And after you hit like 40, you only dance from here up. You know?
You do?
None of this work. So it's all up in here now. You know? So that's the only move I got.
Well, let me show you a little bit of like, okay, so the scissor move involves a body roll, like a thrusting.
Oh.
But at the same time, you're going like this.
Yes.
So, and then you kind of like switch it up.
Yes.
So this is like,
the scissor. So the scissor. Should... I think I saw Genuine do that last night. Except when he did it, I looked in his eyes. Give me a beat so I can see that scissor move again.
Are you gonna do it with me?
Okay, this here. But see this part right here?
Yeah.
I don't know about that part. Thank you, Yvonne. Go see I, Frankenstein in theaters next Friday. So there's a scissor part, and there's this part, and then I gotta put those two together. We'll be back.